Hello and welcome to another stream from Game Systems TV of Forza Motorsport 5. Glad to have you all around. If you just tuned in, we've only just started streaming, so you haven't missed anything, so don't worry. Just going to play this in the background while I do my little bit of a speech at the beginning like I normally do on the stream. There we go. Alright, coming up on today's stream then, we will be seeing some more races by the Mini that you see on the screen now. Streaming earlier than I thought we would be. To be honest, I'm surprised we're actually doing a stream today. Considering we did one later on last night, and the time today... Ooh, what's the time? I haven't even got my phone on me, so I can't even see. It's about 9 o'clock in the morning in the UK. But we are streaming live, so if you are watching this on YouTube, this is a recorded version of a live stream. And thanks for choosing Game Systems TV to watch the stream of Forza Motorsport 5. Now, Game Systems TV is like a spin-off to our normal website, which is gamesystems.co.uk. If you are a customer of gamesystems.co.uk, you can follow us on our Twitch channel. Now, our Twitch channel is twitch.tv/gamesystemsTV. This is basically just our gaming community of our normal website, and it just gets customers involved in the bits that we do here at Game Systems. Now you can either get involved with in the ways of the chat, or you can challenge us if you've got Forza 5, challenge us to races and other bits and bobs to do with Forza 5 as we're streaming live. Now, if you do enjoy our streams, because not only do we just play the games during the streams, we do have our gaming news, which keeps all new customers up to date with all the latest gaming news and gaming announcements that are made in the world of gaming from the publishers that we deal with. We do deal with, I'm trying to think how many publishers we deal with. We do deal with quite a few. I think we deal with like 19 publishers. It's over 18 or 19 publishers across the world. So we do have quite a catalogue of publishers that we deal with. If you do work for any of those publishers and you see our stream, they're just there, hit us up on the chat and say hello. We'd love to hear from anybody that watches this stream. Whether you're watching this live or whether you're watching this on YouTube. If you're watching this on YouTube, then yeah, just please leave any comments in the bit below the video. Let us know what you think of our stream. Any improvements that you'd like to see us do, or whether you like to make some kind of contribution to our stream, as the ways of what games you'd like to see us play in the future, or what you'd like to see us do in this game, for instance, Forza Motorsport 5. So, yeah, please get involved. We do offer perks to customers that do follow us. So if you do or are interested in our streams and you do like them, then whether you're watching this live on Twitch or whether you're watching them on YouTube, or if you're watching the past broadcasts either on Twitch or either on YouTube, then head over to our main page, our main Twitch page, which is twitch.tv/gamesystemsTV, where you can follow us there. You'll get to know exactly when we're streaming. Like I said, I didn't even think I'd be streaming this time of morning, but we are. And if you weren't following, you wouldn't know when we went live. So if you follow us on Twitch, you will get that alert as to when we go live. Or if you follow us on Twitter, then you'll also get that notification as to when we go live, because that's all set up there. So as soon as we go live, you get that tweet sent to you with a link to click on the link, and you can come straight to our stream. As I said before, if you're new to our stream, then what we tend to do is we normally stream on average for a couple of hours, especially if we're playing something like Forza Motorsport 5, then the stream only goes on for a couple of hours, no more than 3 hours really. And if you are watching the stream live, get involved in our chat, or you will get to know about different things that we mention, i.e. gaming news, as well as offers that we do have on our website. So if you are within the UK, head over to our website at gamesystems.co.uk and purchase anything there. Like I said before, I didn't get to finish off what I was saying, so I moved on to something else, but with the perks that you get, now this only applies to UK residents, if you were to follow us on Twitch, anyone in the UK will be given 25 purchase points added to their account at gamesystems.co.uk. How this works is you would go onto our website, you'd make any purchase. We've got over 4,000 products on the website, so there's a lot to choose from, ranging from games, consoles, accessories, gaming merchandise, bits and bobs for your phone. We're even adventuring now into kids' toys. So make any purchase. Once you've purchased, obviously in the checkout part, you'd end up setting up your account. And once that's done, come over to Twitch, go onto our page, which is, again, twitch.tv/GameSystemsTV, follow us, and once you've followed, we will be sending out a code to you. I don't even know why I'm mentioning codes, because you're basically getting 25 points, so the 25 points will automatically be added to your account. I remember mentioning this yesterday, I was thinking, it's not codes, is it? Forget the code bit, ain't gonna bother you with all that. It's even simpler than that. Your points will be automatically added to your account. There is no code. Right. Moving swiftly on then. We are going to start the race today in the Mini again. Almost finished this series of the Vintage series with the Mini. So let's see what race we're in today. I think we're going to go to Long Beach, USA.
We now head back to scenic Southern California for an event at the Temporary Street Circuit in Long Beach.
So yesterday, on the previous stream, even if you're watching this on YouTube, which is obviously recorded to yourselves, we did race in the Swiss Alps, and then we did it was kind of a little task to get between barrels across on the sleeping track, and I managed to smash the gold. I haven't checked out if that actually qualifies for an actual gold medal yet. Go into the actual car bit and go into specifications where it shows you its value, and yeah, its top speed. It also tells you how many gold medals it's won. I don't know if doing that little challenge classes as a gold medal. I'll have to have a look. I didn't check that actually. This is just a standard race that we're doing. in the Vintage League, so I will be racing against other classic cars, such as, likewise, Minis, Beetles, and what else have we got in there? Oh, Elans. I haven't got the fastest Mini on the track. I know I haven't. If you have been watching previous streams, then you will know that very basic mods have been done to this car. And the car has a lot more work left to go on it. But during the course of this stream, as well as future streams, you will see more and more modifications done to this car. Right, let's head into the race then, see how we get on. See if I can actually get a decent finishing position. As always, he's always slow off the line, but it does catch up to him. That was. I actually am going to rewind that. Something's prompting me there to get some decent tyres on it, because the handling isn't that great. Either it was my fault or it was the car's fault. Yeah, probably my fault. Oh, we have a pile up here. Now, I have got the difficulty on simulation, so I'm trying not to hit them as much as possible, because it will mechanically damage my car, and basically the race is very painful if you do mechanically damage a car, and you will end up last. I haven't really got any assists on, apart from the braking assist, which shows you when it's best to brake, you know, for the corner. Other than that, that's pretty much it. The driver tar difficulty is on average, so it's not easy and it's not hard. Good thing about the Mini is it can squeeze through these little tight corners, although it doesn't have the power out of the corners, as just shown there. I thought I could take that corner faster than I could. Sometimes I don't always get the braking assist on the track. sometimes it tells you to brake, and you know you can actually do that corner faster than what it's actually telling you you can do it. So, like there, at that point there, it was telling me to lift off. You see, I'm powering on now. So yeah, still got power on. Not didn't brake when they told me to. The cut in. There we go. If I'd listened to him, I probably wouldn't have got that position. Although I'm going to lose it because of the car just hasn't got the speed. Now, modifications that will be placed on this car will should hopefully make it quicker. Now, I'm not too bothered about top end speed. I'm more worried about the acceleration, the quickness of the car. Can't keep him at bay, really. Oh, I should have gone over there. Oh, well, he's pushed him out. Now, I do have an Elan, as you know, and as much as I like to race my Elan, I can't compete in this. This event anymore because the car's got too much performance work done to it. Oh no! I'm gonna have to settle for 15th, won't I? I know. I've just gotta hold him off now. That was very close. I almost lost it to him then because he just sneaked on the inside. Alright, so 14th place finished now. I think I could do better than that. The only thing that gets me is that last straight. Because the car just doesn't have the power to do a fast top end speed. So, unfortunately, any cars I overtook in the previous corners, especially the last couple, end up catching up. We'll give it another go. ever get on. Now, I've checked out some other streams of Forza Motorsport, but actually, like, once I finish the stream, I have a look who else is streaming now. In that period, then, just before I started this race, I did have a quick look at who else is streaming. There's one other person streaming this game, but what I have found is a lot of people stream online races, which is one of the reasons why I'm not streaming an online race, because why be the same as everybody else? I'm sure people want to see something different than tuning into five different streamers all streaming the same thing. Yeah, sometimes, you know, I don't get Twitch half the time. Main reasons is because it's always the same top three games that are being watched, like League of Legends or Dota or I don't know what the other one. Counter-Strike is also quite popular. I don't understand why everyone watches the same games all the time. There's thousands of games on Twitch. Everyone seems to watch the same thing. Right, so 12th place there. Yeah? I thought I'd be quiet throughout that race to see if it helps my concentration a bit. Didn't do me too bad. Higher than the race before anyway. Maybe that's the problem, maybe I talk too much. Or maybe it was a view I had it in, maybe. So one or two. Alright, let's start this race again then. Oh yeah, and it wasn't my dodgy driver in the last race, so I'm going to try to take me out on that corner. I tried to slide line all over the place. Let's see, again, someone's going to take me out. Smash on the side. That was awful. I'm going to do that again because I was going far too fast. I knew I was. I just thought I could take that corner better, but unfortunately, the car right in the way. Oh, now I proper damaged the car again. Too many cars in the way. I have to see how the race pans out from here on, because it's got some suspension damage now. Not playing up too bad though, considering. Either you get suspension damage, either pulls to the left or... Well, did pull a bit to the right there when I broke. That's the only trouble, being far down the grid is there's far too many cars in the way. While driving, it's not pulling left or right or anything, nor is the suspension bouncing all over the place, so it hasn't affected the performance too bad. But I'm sure you just saw then, as I just braked, it did pull a bit to the right. Probably handy if you are turning, right? Take out those cones and smash into the arse end of him. See, it's really affecting the steering. They struggle at that corner. And unfortunately, while going slow around that corner in order to get round the corner, these the cars behind more speed to get past me. I was trying to get out on the inside and then they just got in the way. Still in the way. Still going for that 12th place. As I'm trying for 12th, I end up falling to 15th. Brilliant. I'm going to finish in that position. Still another couple of corners ago. So the suspension's gone on it. So I just cheated a little bit there, just holding the cars off. So that 13th. Doesn't seem to want to show me. Yeah, I think it's 13th. Not entirely happy with that, because I have done better. I took a bit of a whack at the back there, that's what the light's dented in. Look at that. Right, that's it. One last time. I've got 12 to beat so far in this race. I'm at 12. So, I'm gonna give it a go. Eleven would do me fine. It's as much as I can ask for with this car and its modified state. At the moment, it's not been heavily modified. It's only got a few mods to it, a few basic mods. That's about it. As I said before, I like a challenge. cars are ramming their way through. I thought he hit the barrier. Yeah, I thought he was going far too fast that corner. Look at him there. Oh, joking. How did I catch him? Obviously, he underestimated the width of this car. Yet again, bit of suspension damage, but not affecting the overall. Pulling a brake and start towing to the left. See, a heavy brake. No, it's pulling right. The brakes are damaged as well, so brakes aren't the best. Why are they trying to take me out? What's going on? I think I only went wide on that corner because he hit me wide. Only a little. That's completely my fault. I was too busy looking at what position I was in. I'm gonna have to rewind that. I thought I could get away with it by trying to handbrake it around the corner. It didn't quite work, I still ploughed into them. To be honest, I've lost all hope now to even getting higher than 14th. There's no way I'm going to catch up with 13th place. Look at the bottom left. The map, look at the gap. I should be quite fortunate not 16th. into 14th place. No better than what I did in the first race. So level 65 then. That's it for that race. I ain't gonna get any higher than that. I am gonna, however, go back and add another bit of modification to it. Does need something for performance wise. And if you look, I mean, it's still even got a standard exhaust, I haven't got modified exhaust. Increases its acceleration and launch. Yeah. Adds 4 horsepower to it. And it's a cheap mod, so we'll see how we get on with that one. Now, this is the mod I should actually get. Has quite a significant bit of power onto it, 11 horsepower. Now I have upgraded this to a supercharger, but it doesn't actually add a lot of performance, not as much as I thought it was going to add. If you have just tuned in, thanks for choosing Game Systems TV to watch Forza Motorsport 5. And as the title suggests, that's what we are playing. If you have been watching the stream for quite a while now, thank you very much. We do appreciate all the viewers we get. So I do actually give a little thank you out to people that do actually watch the stream. If you'd like to return the favour, then head over to our main Twitch page, which is Game Systems TV, and give us a follow. By following us, you will end up finding out when we stream next. Now, we don't stream the same time, same time every day. We do stream at various different times, so by following us you will get to find out when we next stream by getting those Twitch notifications. Failing that, if you don't want to follow us on Twitch, if you don't have a Twitch account, you can follow us on Twitter at twitter.com/GameSystemsUK, and there you'll get a link to our stream, and you also get a tweet. Give you a notification as to when we go live. Now, we do give out perks to every customer that follows us, especially if you're in the UK. If you are a UK watcher, then what we're giving away this month is 25 purchase points to your gamesystems.co.uk account. So for every customer that follows us on Twitch will get 25 purchase points added to their account at gamesystems.co.uk. To do this, head over to gamesystems.co.uk, make a purchase from the 4,000 products that we have in stock. We have games, consoles, accessories, gaming merchandise, toys, like kids' toys, other little bits and bobs. We've even got power banks for phones and stuff like that, and we are branching out into doing more a variety of stuff as well. So head over to that, make any purchase on our website. By doing that, obviously you set up your account. Once you've made your purchase, head over to twitch.tv/gamesystemsTV, follow us, and we will add 25 purchase points to your account. With those points, you will get bigger discounts on games, such as if you don't have this game and you're enjoying watching us play this game and you want to have a go yourself, or you fancy getting the game just to challenge us, and if you want to challenge us live on Twitch, then you can head over to our gamer tag, which is SonicPain24. Send us a message or an invite, and challenge us live on Twitch. This is also getting recorded as well and getting put up on our YouTube page. So for everyone that's watching this on YouTube as well, bear that in mind and let us know. Either for our gamer tag or if you'd like to be watching this on YouTube, put it down in the comments or add your gamer tag in the comments and we'll message you. Now for you guys that are watching live on Twitch right now, get involved in the chat, let us know your thoughts of the stream so far, what you'd like to see, what you'd like to see us change, or what you know, any gaming topics you want to talk about, or whether you want to talk amongst yourselves, that's totally fine. Now, Game Systems TV is a gaming community, and is a gaming community side of our main website, which is gamesystems.co.uk, and on this gaming community we do invite you gamers or watchers, whoever you may be, to get involved in the chat and basically talk about anything you like. Coming up in the stream then, we have got some more races from the Mini, which is currently on screen now. But first, before we move on to that, as I mentioned in the stream as well, something that's always a main feature of our streams is the gaming talk that we have. We have our little 10-minute section of gaming talks. Now in this gaming talk you get to find out about the offers that we have on our website, as well as any information that have been given to us from the 18 publishers that we deal with and that we have contracts with. Something that we're like obliged to mention out on our Twitch feeds. It keeps the publishers happy and does us favours as well. Now, as I've mentioned before, we do sell new pre-owned and you can pre-order games at gamesystems.co.uk. And just flicking through what we've got on offer, these offers are going to be ending very shortly, so if it is something you want, then it's probably best to head over as soon as possible. A lot of focus at the moment is on Xbox One and PS4, other games, accessories, consoles themselves. But for you guys that have still got your Xbox 360s, you can pick up a brand new copy of Halo 3 ODST for $8.99. Now, this is only available to UK residents, so if you are watching and you are in the UK, you can head over to gamesystems.co.uk now and pick up your copy of Halo 3 ODST for just $8.99. This is a brand new sealed copy as well, it's not a pre-owned copy. But like I said, these offers are due to end very soon. Now, as I said, we like to mention any bit of information we get from our publishers. Now looking at what's on our Twitter feed, what we've been sent over from Nintendo UK is that they've got something on the eShop for the 3DS called Musicverse. That's an electronic keyboard that you can make your own tunes using the touchscreen of the 3DS. Maybe you've got 3DS, 2DS, it should be the same thing really. If you've got either one of the two, then you can get this for it. Like I said, you make your own tunes and I think you can record it. If you head over to, if you are on Twitter and you head over to Twitter, use the hashtag 3DS or hashtag eShop. There is, you then will see a tweet from Nintendo UK and there is a link there to click on. It shows you all about Musicverse and how to get it. Also, if you have got a 3DS, you can go onto the eShop. There is more information on there about it as well. Now, a game that's next coming out is on Tuesday, which is Tom Clancy's The Division. And Ubisoft UK has tweeted, good job, Agent. Bring the code back to base for a chance to win. Now, use the hashtag HuntTheDarkZones on Twitter, and you can get a code for the Division. Also, there is a chance there to win now looking at it, I've just gone and done this myself. I'm even going to cheat here. I'm going to tell you what the code is. The code is NBHPUKPLLA. Now if you're watching this live, this is something you might want to take notice of. If you're watching this pre-recorded, it's done and gone by now, I'm sure. But if you reply to that with that code, you can be in the chance of winning Nvidia GeForce GTX. That code again is NBHPUKPLLA. So look in on Twitter, use the hashtag HuntTheDarkZones for your chance to win a Nvidia GeForce GTX. They've also got another code here. It's I've grabbed. It says today compete in the G. The Go 4R6 Cup to prevail to win the weekly prize. No hashtag here, so I can't direct you to that. But there is a link there, and it is to do. From what I'm getting from the link, it's to do with Rainbow Six. So it should be Rainbow Six Siege, which is the Go 4R6 Cup. Now, we don't really get a great deal of gaming news on a Sunday, but I will have a quick search and see what I can find. Now, searching here, I don't think there's anything really new than what I mentioned in the last stream. Not really. But I have got something different, what I haven't mentioned yet. So, for you guys, you got your PS4s and playing Street Fighter V, there is a rage quitting penalty system. So if you're playing online and you get into a rage because you're getting beat, and you quit that fight, you will get a penalty. Capcom have announced that their hand will be handed down to offending players, plus they're also announcing DLCs as well, so which are looking like extra characters and bits and bobs added to Street Fighter 5. But the main topic there is if you do get in a rage while playing online Street Fighter 5 and you quit during the match, you will get a penalty against you. I know how people feel. I have played online, I played Tekken online before, and unfortunately I have felt like quitting because there was a lot of people that do button bashing and one move wonders. And also I played against King once, someone had King character, and they did this combo which from start to finish I didn't even get one shot in. So yeah, I do understand the frustration. The Remedy creative director, Sam Lake, has cleared up the confusion with the announcement of a new Alan Wake. He says that, sorry, Alan Wake's return is not a game. So this is reference to Alan Wake's Return, which is the name of the game, which isn't a game. Obviously a lot of people think that there is a new game, new Alan Wake game, and the title of it is Alan Wake's Return, but this isn't a game. I think it's an add-on DLC, a bit like that, I can't remember, was it Alan Wake's Nightmare? Something like that. So yeah, for you Alan Wake fans, Alan Wake, the new one, which is called Alan Wake's Return, is not going to be a game, it's just going to be DLC again. So, obviously it's going to cause frustration again, because there's been a few big DLCs for Alan Wake. They've only done one game, one proper game. The rest of them have just been like basically DLCs. So there will be a bit of disappointment for fans there. Now, Microsoft again are in the news. And the Xbox executive responds to PC gaming monopoly concerns. Windows has always been an open ecosystem, welcoming the contributions of hardware and software partners, and will always continue to be, says the CEO of Xbox. Earlier today, Epic Games CEO Tim Sweeney wrote an impassioned and thorough breakdown of Microsoft's universal Windows platforms, accusing the company of monopolizing PC games development. He went as far to say that the platform can and should and must there's a bit of a slanderous comments there can, should, must and will die as a result of industry backlash. Microsoft quickly responded saying that Universal Windows platform is a fully ecosystem available to every developer that can be supported by any store. Xbox executive Phil Spencer has weighed in too. Across a series of tweets, Spencer and Windows said that Windows has been and will always continue to be an open ecosystem. He went on to say that more details on Microsoft's plans will be discussed at the company's Build conference later this month. Sweeney also chimed in saying he is encouraged by Spencer's tweets and looks forward to what will be shared at this Build. So there's a bit of a slanging match there, and I have got the list of all these tweets that have been sent by Phil Spencer and Tim Sweeney. For lots more on the story, you can check out the in-depth SoundCloud interview Polygon conducted with Sweeney. In it, he talks about why he's so concerned with Microsoft's move, why he's speaking up now, and how things could be fixed in his estimation. He also reveals that he spoke with Xbox executives, including Phil Spencer, more than a year ago about his concerns. Now, I don't know why he's getting so involved in what Xbox are doing with their games on Xbox and Windows. I don't understand why he's getting so involved and why he's so concerned about it. To be honest, if you know, he reckons Microsoft will die in the gaming industry. I don't think it's due to them cross-platforming their games on PC. I think it will be to do with the fact that the sales of the PS4 are so high. You know, Microsoft are losing sales on their Xbox One console, and it has been warned that if they don't step it up like Nintendo have to, then they will not be around for the next generation, therefore only leaving Sony in the next generation to make a PlayStation 5, so there won't be no competition in the market, and basically Sony will win. Sony will have a new console in the next generation, which probably, and is speculated, not to be a physical console. It's more like to be something like a dongle, like what Chrome is, the Chromecast, and be plugged straight into your TV. Or something even like PlayStation TV itself, and you can play games. So basically I think the whole industry is going to get destroyed if the only company left in the gaming industry is Sony, which is something I don't want to see happen. That's why we're trying to support Microsoft with the Xbox and try and get more sales towards the Xbox One, because obviously we want that more competition in the market. We want games to still be physical and not all downloadable games or streaming games. Yeah, it will ruin the gaming industry as we know it. So, yeah, let us know your thoughts about that in the chat. What you think to what I've just said, and what you think to Tim Sweeney's concerns with Microsoft cross-platforming their Xbox One games and PC games. Like I announced in the previous stream, that Microsoft are planning on making every single Xbox One game playable on Windows 10. So, you know, let us know your thoughts to that. Now, we are going to be taking a quick break. If you bear with us 5 minutes, I will be back. But I'm going to go and grab a quick drink and hopefully see you again in 5. Right, I'm back. Sorry to keep you all waiting there. I think it's more like 10 minutes than 5, isn't it? Right, if you haven't been waiting patiently throughout those, I think it's about 10 minutes, thank you ever so much. Do appreciate it. If you have just joined, thanks for joining Game Systems TV. As the title suggests, we are playing Forza Motorsport 5. For you guys that are already watching before the break, and you did enjoy the stream, then please head over to our Twitch channel, which is twitch.tv/GameSystemsTV, where you can follow us and you'll get all the latest information from us, as well as seeing our previous streams, and you also get notifications as to when we go live. So if you want to see another one of our streams, then please follow us and you'll get that information as soon as we go live. If you don't have a Twitch account and you're unable to follow us because you don't have a Twitch account, we are on Twitter as well. So if you go on to Twitter, twitter.com that is, /GameSystemsUK, you can follow us on Twitter and you'll get a notification or a tweet even as to when we go live. In that tweet will be a link to our live stream. Just click on it and you'll head straight here. For those of you watching on YouTube, thanks for choosing to watch Game Systems TV's live stream of Forza Motorsport 5. To you guys watching on YouTube, it isn't live, it's recorded live. It's only live to the guys that are watching on Twitch right now. So anything you want to add in the comments below, please do. Same applies to you guys watching on Twitch. Anything you want to mention in the chat, anything you want to talk about in the chat, then please get involved. That could be anything from gaming subjects, gaming topics, to comments you want to make about our stream, what you like about the stream, what you don't like about the stream, anything you think we can improve in the stream, then please let us know in the chat. Or whether you guys want to just talk amongst yourselves, that is also fine. But yeah, we do love it when you guys get involved in the chat. Yeah, again, for you guys that haven't got a Twitch account and can't get involved in the chat because you don't have a Twitch account, as if you can, head over to YouTube. Check us out at youtube.com/GameSystems. That is our main channel on YouTube. You can send us messages or comments over there. Failing that, if you guys want to challenge us to a race on Forza Motorsport 5, or want to challenge us to any game really, we don't just have an Xbox One, we do have a 360 and we have access to over 400 games. So anything you want to challenge us on, head over to or search for the gamertag SonicPain24. That's Sonic as in the hedgehog and Pain as in P-A-I-N 24, and send us a message or an invite. To you guys either watching on Twitch or YouTube and you want to follow us on Twitch, head over to our main Twitch page, like I said, twitch.tv/GameSystemsTV, and give us a follow. Like I said, you guys who are within the UK and do follow us will get something called a Game Systems perk. Now, these are perks we give out to customers for either loyalty or going like cross-platform of our channels. Now, like I said, we are mainly a gaming retail company which trades through our main website, which is gamesystems.co.uk, but we do have our gaming community channel, which is our Twitch channel, which is Gamesystems TV. Now, for customers of Gamesystems UK, or for new customers that have never heard of us or just found us out through Twitch, can head over to gamesystems.co.uk and use to customers. So if you are UK and you do want to follow us on Twitch and make your purchase on our website at gamesystems.co.uk. Once you made your purchase and once you've added all your account details, which would be name, address, bits and bobs like that, just so you can also pay for your purchase, once that's all done, we will add 25 purchase points to your account, which will give you a bigger discount on your next order. Now, if you're thinking about making an order with us, then we do have quite a few games on offer at the moment. We do have over 4,000 products in stock, ranging from games, consoles, gaming accessories, merchandise. There's bits and bobs of your phone, and also we just started doing kids' toys as well. So we do have quite a broad range of products on our website to choose from. So if you are stuck or can't think of anything right now, head over to our website at gamesystems.co.uk. Give you some bit of inspiration as to what to get for your next purchase. Now, before we move on in the stream and see a bit more racing from the Mini that's currently on your screen, we are going to just add a bit more gaming news to the stream. Just looking up here, Minimoto, I think that's how you pronounce the name, Japanese guy to do with Nintendo, Miyamoto, I think that sounds right. Yeah, Miyamoto really enjoyed the Star Wars The Force Awakens. He says that he was discouraged by the CG-heavy prequel trilogy, but was very impressed with the latest entry. So, I take it that he means he doesn't like the CG bits, but does like or is very impressed with the actual story of the actual film itself. There's some top selling PSN games for February 2016. Now, this was only announced a day ago, but goes on to let customers know what the biggest selling PlayStation Network games for February 2016 was. I'm not going to go into it, it's too long to go into it, but if you want to check it out, you can check it out. It's on GameSpot's website. There's also, yeah, there's a list there of the top 7 PlayStation Network games. But something I will mention, because we do have a lot of PC gamers on Twitch, so there's something, you know, for everyone here for most of you guys on Twitch that are PC gamers. Most of you, well, I would say about 90% of the PC gamers will have a Steam account, so this probably will interest you if you do have a Steam account, and be pleased to know that Steam have lots of Square Enix games discounted in the new Steam sale. Now, Steam's latest publisher sale has begun. This one focuses on PC titles from the Japanese publisher Square Enix. Now, through Monday, the March the 7th, you can save on games in Final Fantasy, Hitman, Just Cause, Thief, and Deus Ex franchises. Games are marked down in some cases as much as 85%, so there's up to 85% off of these Square Enix games. Now, I've only got the American prices, the US dollar, but I'm sure if you head over to Steam, within the country you are in, it is converted into your currency, so you will get to find out what that is. But if you are good with your currencies, you might be able to work out what the difference is between these prices and what they are in your country. In terms of new releases, Riser Tomb Raider is marked down to $48, while Just Cause 3 is available for $40. If you don't have Just Cause 3, that is definitely a game worth getting. There's a few good Square Enix games here that are on offer, so it is worth getting. Just Cause 3 is definitely worth getting. $40, pretty good price. You've got older titles like Just Cause, the first one, which is $1.74, and Just Cause 2, which is $3.74, as well as Hitman Absolution, the Elite Edition, for $6.24, almost a £6 then, $6.24, and a Deus Ex Human Revolution Director's Cut for $5, are also discounted in the sale. There are plenty of markdown Final Fantasy games as well, including Final Fantasy Typo HD, $15. Now, do not waste your $15, the game's rubbish, so don't get that game. But if you do want a Final Fantasy game, definitely get Lightning Returns Final Fantasy 13. Now, that is a game worth getting if you're into your Final Fantasy. So there are my favourite Final Fantasy games, and there are also games I hate of the Final Fantasy series. This Typo HD is a complete waste of time, so don't waste your money on games like that. I have got a copy of the game myself, played it, and it's not very good. It's, like I mentioned in previous streams before, it is like a glorified demo, so try and stay away from that game. And you can also get Final Fantasy VII, which is $6, among many others as well. You can head over to the Square Enix Publisher Weekend landing page this weekend. So, yeah, if you're watching this live on Twitch right now, head over to Steam and you can see the Square Enix page there, where you can get these games from. Regardless of what country you're in, if you're in the UK, or if you're in the US, Australia, or anywhere else in Europe, then head over to Steam, and like these games will be in your currency, so you'll get to know what they are. Like I said, I've only got US prices, so for you US watchers, then they are accurate as of today. If you're watching this on YouTube, then probably by this time the offers have finished. So, don't always go by what I've just said. Doesn't tell me exactly how long these offers are on for, so all I know is that it starts on March the 7th, which is tomorrow. Now, checking our Twitter feed here from the publisher that we deal with. We always do. We always check what the publishers like to talk about. And just having a quick look here. I don't know. Someone's tweeted something. It's in a different language. I'm going to have to see if I can convert it into English. I can't understand what it says. It's talking about Far Cry Primal. Here we go. Drug Prehistoric Far Cry Primal, it's official. That's to do with Prison Gaming UK, so if you check out Prison Gaming UK's Twitter page, there's links there to a YouTube video to do with kind of like a drug effect on Far Cry Primal, so check that out. They've also tweeted a tweet from Vertigo about their first epic card in Clash Royale. Apparently they're a noob, so there's also, while you're there on Prison Gaming's Twitter page, you can get a link there to their YouTube video. And one of them as well, there's also another one about Crazy Splash. There's a Crazy Splash glitch in Call of Duty Black Ops 3, where you can get free nukes in the Awakening DLC. So while you're on Prison Gaming's Twitter page, you can check out that YouTube video, which should have how to get those free nukes. Now, as I mentioned before in the stream about the offers that we have on our website, we do cater for all generations, and for you guys that are still on your PlayStation 2s, we have an offer on Happy Feet for PlayStation 2 for just £2.39. It's currently on our website for that offer price at the moment, but like I said, the offers are due to change very soon, so while you can get it, you can get it for £2.39. Bit of retro gaming there for you. Right. Enough of all the gaming talk. And now I'm gonna head into another race in the Mini in the Vintage League. Do you know? I think we should head over to France.
We are heading back to the streets of Le Mans, France, for today's event at the iconic Circuit de la Sarthe.
Now, I've done a little bit of modifications to this Mini. If you're new to the stream and you haven't seen what I've already previously done to the Mini, then I've just changed a few things in the engine. It's had its brakes done, stiffened the suspension, put a stronger arm on it to make it a bit more handle, but better, especially on the front end of the car. There's any bits and bobs on there which help its performance and handling as well. Just put a new exhaust on the car, so it's only added about 4 horsepower onto it, but I still think it's gonna end up round about middle of the grid by the end of this race. Hasn't got enough performance yet to get top of the grid, but it's gradually getting there. There's plans engine wise for this. I've done the supercharger conversion on it, but I haven't actually put the supercharger in it in the engine itself, so it's something that's also yet to be done. Right, let's go. Let's give it a go. Let's see how we end up in this race then. If you haven't watching the stream, then you'll see that I didn't do brilliantly in the last race, which has prompted me to add a bit more horsepower into this car. Hasn't really made much of a difference, I don't think. Still a bit slow at the start. eventually we'll catch up and I will end up getting quite a few cars ahead. Now, if you are new to this stream and you haven't seen me play the previous race, I mentioned the difficulty is on simulation, hence why I've just done what I've just done, which was swerve out the way of the back end of that car, because if I do hit it, I do end up having engine damage. Now, some people ask, why don't you just reverse the rewind it if you do end up doing that? Reason being is because you lose credits by rewinding, if you didn't already know. And defeats the whole object of why I put it on simulation in the first place. Didn't break enough for that corner. I was only going to do a quick dab on the brakes and try and carry it around that corner, but was a bit too sharp. Now the only assist I have got on is the braking line there, as you see. Other than that, I've taken every other assist off and even put it on simulation difficulty. So like I said, if you hit something in the car, then you will have mechanical damage to the car, which does affect its performance and makes for a very painful race if you do end up doing like engine damage or suspension damage. Quite commonly, as I've found out, suspension and brakes get damaged very easily, especially if you hit someone in the back like I almost did then, quite hard. I knew that was going to happen. He cut straight across me. And there you go, that's what happens when you do hit someone quite hard. You will get damage like that. And as you can see, it's affecting my steering. And you see when I brake there, it does bounce a bit and pull to the, I think it's pulling to the right a bit when I brake. Oh, see, there you go. Only two laps in this, and I don't think I'm going to get any higher than 14th. No. I'm just going to blame it on the fact that there was some damage to my car mechanically, the suspension's a bit damaged, hence why it goes a bit wide when you're trying to go around the corners, and it pulls a bit as well when you brake. Oh, it's a good job I got those assists off. It's added some extra bit of money. Oh, they've got only 980 credits. can see on the front end, and I've taken a bit of a whack on the front end, which has contributed to my suspension getting damaged, which then contributed to the performance being a bit downhill, especially with the cornering. Right, I am going to try it again. Now this time I'm going to be quiet throughout this, so I'm not going to speak through the race. Right, there you go. Boy, actually not talking throughout that race. I actually did pretty well. I think it's a distraction of talking. I think when I actually fully concentrate on racing, I actually can actually push this car to its full potential. I've actually got silver in that race, whereas before I wasn't even getting bronze. So yeah, that's pushing the performance of this MIDI and actually giving it a bit more accurate level of where this car's at in performance wise. Because I said when I'm talking and while I'm trying to race, while thinking about what I'm talking about, I'm not really concentrating. Although sometimes it does actually do me some favours. I remember, yeah, before I used to do streaming, used to have loads of thoughts in my head and think about things all the time. I'm thinking or coming up with ideas in my head while I'm racing, forgetting what I'm doing, and then by the end of the race, I won the race. I didn't even know. Or it was about 10 laps, and I've gone through it, racing through, and it feels like there's only a few laps. So, right. Can have another race. This time I will be talking. I'm not going to talk all the way through the race, but I am going to have the mic on. Anything that pops into my head, and I'll give it a mention. Also, I'm going to get back to this view as well. If it was a good thing or bad thing, I don't know. I hate having to go wide just to avoid hitting the cars. But they still with me though. See, that's what I mean about having to go wide, just so you don't contact them. Because like I said, the difficulty is simulation, so if I do have quite heavy contact with them, it will affect my performance of my car. I'm trying to avoid them as much as I can. Doing too badly so far, eh? Managed to get up to 10th, which is better than what I did in my first race. And I finished 14th, I think it was, in my first race. And the second race on this track, I did 6th. So. I don't think I'm going to beat 6th, though. It's going to take some going. Depends how the race pans out. These cars in front of me end up making some mistakes. Like that one there going off the track. There's only two laps in this race, so I don't get much of a chance to climb up the grid. But if this car was overpowered for the race, as in the most powerful car on the track, then two races are enough really and easy. Trying to get 8th before they finish. I'm going to try and get this car right in the end, on the last corner. There you go. That'll do me. Eighth. So, still bronze, eh? That's something I didn't check earlier. I was going to check if, that gold medal I got from the race before the previous one by going through the barrels actually contributed to an actual proper gold medal. Add it to my tally, I think that would be 5 gold medals. I should have anyway. Not bad for a car that's only got a few modifications. So that's Affinity level 18 now. And more percentage payout, higher percentage payout. Right. Right, last race then. Now, the reason why we decided to go back to doing the streams of Forza Motorsport 5 is because it happened to be our most popular streams. The Evil Within was quite popular as well, but it was proven that Forza Motorsport 5 was the most popular of three games that we played. Zero's being the least. Then it is an Xbox Live game and not everyone knows it exists. So probably explains that, whereas Forza Motorsport 5 and the Evil Within are quite big and popular games. Yeah, it explains a few things. Definitely explains our statistics as to the popularity of streams. Have to dart on the inside there because I don't want to end up doing severe damage to the car. And I don't mind a bit of rough and tumble with these cars, but as long as they don't do severe damage to me, or mechanical damage. Cut right on the inside there, brilliant, I avoided that incident. Got beat 6th. So far, 6th is the highest place I've got in this race so far. Currently, well, I'll be 7th now. So currently 7th, I've got to beat 6th. I've got to get 2 more places up. Now, knowing some of the corners I've got left in this last lap, I should hopefully get a few cars ahead. Nah, that's just cheating, that is. Trying to take me out there. I don't see somehow I'm going to beat 6th. No, I'm slipping further and further down. I'm not even going to get a bronze medal this week. I'm sure I will, though. I'm sure I'll get bronze. Oh, I hate that bit. That's popping. I think that's ruined my chances now. Oh no, I just want bronze. Come on. Can't get this car in the last corner. Come on, oh no! That's gone trying too hard. Tenth place. I don't believe it. I really thought I was going to get ninth there, but never mind. Oh well, apparently it's bronze anyway for tenth. Get bronze for 10th, but it is. Right, that would do for that, Mason. Now, the exhaust has helped a little bit there, so added a bit more power to the car. While I'm there, still gonna do nothing to it. Doesn't really show up much on these statistics there. Doesn't really add much to it, but it does help with the handling of the car anyway. It only gives you a mild upgrade, but still. It's something there that does actually help. Now, differential needs doing. There's a few things this car needs doing. It's not had a lot of work done to it. As you can see. If you just joined the stream, thanks for joining Game Systems TV, streaming Forza Motorsport 5. Do appreciate all you viewers that tune in. If you've been watching for at least the last 10 minutes or throughout the stream, Really appreciate you tuning in to watch Game Systems TV. If you guys are currently watching, especially live on Twitch, and you have been enjoying the stream so far, then please head over to our main Twitch page, which is twitch.tv/GameSystemsTV, where you can follow us to find out future streams. You'll get notifications as soon as we go live. If you don't have a Twitch account and therefore unable to follow us, you can follow us on Twitter, which is twitter.com/GameSystemsUK, and you'll get notifications as to when we go live for a tweet, which will feature a link to go straight to our stream. If you're watching this on YouTube, this is recorded live. It isn't live when you watch it, but it is recorded live. So anything does normally happen during the stream, and I don't always make complete sense, but I do try, and I do end up making mistakes during my speech as well. Whenever I'm talking, I end up making mistakes. So I can't edit any of this out. But for the you guys that are watching on YouTube and then join the stream, you can check out our main YouTube page. This also applies to you guys watching on Twitch as well. Check out our main YouTube page, which is youtube.com/GameSystems, and you can check out all our previous streams on there. You'll be able to find out, you'll be able to find our previous streams of Forza Motorsport 5. We also had The Evil Within, and we also did Zeros as well, which is an Xbox Live game. They're all uploaded on